On Hatteberg's People, Erika Nelson of Lucas, Kansas, believes art can change communities, uplift our spirit, make us smile, and take our minds to new heights. Erika, too, is unique and uses her art to educate and uplift.
I do what I do, which is exploring the American road, looking for things that are odd, unusual, really reflective of place, because I'm drawn to the stories behind them.
In her traveling exhibit, Erika hosts the world's largest collection of the world's smallest versions of the world's largest things.
I used to travel to the sites in the Mobile Museum, photograph the world's largest things, then create the small model and place it in the passenger side windows. So whenever the bus is not moving, you can see the displays. You can also see them when it's moving, but it's a little harder at 70 miles an hour. So the displays end up getting placed in the windows with little markers of where they are from, what they are, like the world's largest penny in Woodruff, Wisconsin, which is a wonderful, sweet story about a lady who is also doing something impossible, building a hospital for her rural community by gathering a million pennies in the 1950s.
And there is, of course, the humorous side of Erika evident in the backyard, like this shoe tree.
I already have a cherry tree, which is a tree full of chairs. There's usually a little bit of a pause for things to sink in, and then there's a laugh. So people who've grown up with puns get them immediately. People who don't usually have that sort of effect to them.
And then there is the art car. With dinosaurs on top and a roadway / tar pit on the hood, it's a teaching tool.
And it is an homage to the open road and the things that I love so dearly. Whenever I use it for school programs, I can also talk about the fossil fuels that we're burning as we go down the road in the tar bed area. But then on the driver's side is a mural of these odd, wonderful, unique things that I'm looking for on the American road.
Erika is certainly non-traditional, but it didn't start out that way.
Part of that is finding your passion, following it, and trusting your decisions, even if they're not the mainstream decisions or not that path that's been laid out for you. Everything metal that wasn't being used in another project got attached to Dojangles because she jangles.
And then there is the world's smallest mural on the side of her home.
And it was created in celebration of Kansas's 150th birthday. And the idea was to create an entire mural in one day.
But she didn't stop there. She painted another gigantic mural on the side of a downtown Lucas building depicting life in post-rock country.
So the mural was designed to be a narrative of the immigrant ancestors who quarried the rock, how the rock influenced the way that this area was settled. I just like playing with the material, seeing what they're supposed to do, and then pushing them to see what they weren't supposed to do but can do.
Erika is a can-do artist on her own road, in her own way.
And it's been a great, amazing journey.